Gitty Gang Show on Cigarbox Nation TV. It's the Gitty Gang Show on Cigarbox Nation TV. And we're coming to you live from CB Gitty. It's the Gitty Gang Show.
Gitty Gang Show.
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 It's the Gitty Gang Show on Cigar Box Nation TV.
Mostly figured that one out about 3 minutes before the show started. So on the road again, here we are with the Gitty Gang Show. Thank you all for joining us once again on this kickoff of the Memorial Day weekend here in the United States. I know everyone around the country is experiencing different weather up here in the great and beautiful Northeast. It's going to be pretty darn cold and pretty darn wet this weekend. And guess who? Going camping.
Better you than me.
Oh, it's going to be awesome, isn't it?
Yep.
Up in beautiful spot, White Lake, right on a lake, nice state park campground.
I think whenever there's a drought, you ought to go camping.
Yeah, it brings the big storms right in. So yeah, that'll be interesting. We'll see. But a couple of announcements. Very special day for multiple reasons. One of those reasons is that it's Jim Burt's birthday. Happy birthday out there, Jimbo.
Roll Tide.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jimbo. Happy birthday to you.
But wait, there's more. It is also Marty's wife, Gail Tober's birthday, the packing and prepping department of the Wicked Bucker International Corporate Conglomeration up there in Maine. Gail's birthday today, too.
A lot of words.
So, happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Gail.
Happy birthday to you.
glad you were all here with us today. We got some great videos to share. They are so great. I don't even know what they are. Somebody didn't print out a script.
It involves Shane.
Oh, it's some rampant Shanery on today's videos. Shane has been busy. Shane has been busy the last few days, of course, getting our big Memorial Day sale put together. We kicked that off yesterday, and things, all sorts of things, everything is flying out the door. You can hear the terrific banging out there in the shop. The guys are making more stuff. Nick's been packaging kits like a madman. The ladies in shipping are flying around and packing. Oh, it's a wonderful thing. Getting some stuff out there.
Now is the best time to pick up a hubcap roller.
We got a hubcap roller here.
Nothing, but it's a great kit.
What else?
Another surprise, actually.
What surprise? Oh, Danny's got a little something to show off. Why not? Jump right into it, everyone.
It's a steam train. Themed guitar number two.
Number two in the series.
Yep.
He'll come right. He's coming out of the booth. Look out.
Norfolk and Western Railway 611.
Norfolk. Now that's one that's been restored and still running, right?
Yep. And so here is a picture of it.
Ah.
And it was built by the Norfolk and Western Railway's Roanoke, Virginia shop.
Roanoke, Virginia.
Yep.
Yeah, buddy. So that's the second in a series of, I guess we could call it the Live Steam series, because he's commemorating steam.
I thought of that idea before he did.
It's true. commemorating the steam locomotives that are still functioning, that have been restored, and are either like the big boy that he showed you a week or two ago.
Yep.
The Union Pacific Railroad is still running that, doing excursions. Some of them are owned by what they call tourist railroads. Actually, in the entry sequence there, when I'm standing by the fence and the train goes by behind me, that was not green screen. That's a real video of me standing by that fence. That's down in Strasburg, Pennsylvania, not far from where Mr. Shane Spiel lives. And they got a couple of them down there that they're actively running. So yeah,
actually 611, I think, has, I heard somewhere that 611 was going there this year. I don't remember the details, but they do bring in some Norfolk and Western power to visit. Yep.
It's my favorite clip. I will never be able to change that one in the opening, because it's just such a great clip.
It's too, you can't change that one.
Yeah, that was a good day. speaking of Memorial Day coming out, actually, if we got 20 minutes worth of videos, we should probably get one out of the hopper.
Yeah, why don't we start with Michael Copato?
Michael Copato.
Send me in a couple of videos. Thank you, Michael.
We need to do a contest or something where everybody who sends in a video during a month gets entered to win a $100 gift certificate or something. Because we like your videos. I don't know if you've picked up on that. Hopefully, because we say it all the time. But yeah, so is he showing off another build?
Yeah, he's got a mini Altoids pickup.
Mini Altoids tin pickup. All right, by God, let's take a look.
All right, well, let me put this here.
And mash all the buttons.
Hey guys, Michael Copato here in Detroit, Michigan. And do you guys play or make a lot of canjos or other type of tin instruments and want to play them through your amp? Don't necessarily want to put a piezo in them? Do you demo them at shows and want to play but don't want to sell them with a pickup in there? Well, here's a handy little hack that I thought I'd share with you. A little mini Altoid magnetic piezo pickup. And I'll show you how to make it. I'm just gonna use this little guy, this perfectly cute little tin. And as you can see, the piezo fits in perfectly and just buried with hot glue. But I'm not going to put a jack in. I mean, I guess you could tuck it and it would be fine. Instead, in my case, is I like using these gold foil pickups on some guitars, so I have a few.
But I don't use the long cord. So I'm just going to snip this off, you know, long enough that I would use it to wire it into a jack inside of a CBG. And I'm going to use the rest of this for it. So basically, it's just going to come in. Magnets are fun. It's going to come in through a hole here. The piezo is going to fit inside. And I'm going to use, in this case, a couple of these bar magnets, which I'm going to put in the lid. And I'm going to bury them in hot glue, too. But I'm going to put, I think, two of them. And that way it would attach right to the back of the canjo, the bottom of the canjo. I'm going to wire it in. But I'm going to do what I do with all piezos, is I'm going to add a 0.01 UF really tiny capacitor. I mean, this is just, it's probably throwing the camera focus off. But just one of these little capacitors. And that way, that's going to help tame the piezo. I use it whenever I use a disc piezo, even a rod piezo, it benefits. It just helps to cut down on that feedback. And I'm going to fill the entire thing with the hot glue. And it's going to be simple. And like I said, a lot of the canjos are just a round can. So it just clips on and you got the cord, plug it into a jack, and Bob is your uncle. And it even works with my all-steel 1940s license plate guitar.
Well, hey, thank you for sending that in, Michael. I love the DIY showing other folks things you figured out and done. That's a cool Altoids tin pickup there for a canjo and all sorts of other things. So here's a song I wrote a few years back now, that if you've been watching for a while, you've probably heard before, but it's the first time with Danny on harmonica, so it's for Memorial Day. Each year at the end of May, we're asked to pray for the soldiers who have fallen along the way. But it don't seem quite enough, the surface barely scuffed, of what we owe to America's fallen brave. So here's to the soldiers, the sailors and marines, fires and those tossed out at sea. Let's all give thanks in our own way, but not just on Memorial Day, to the ones who died to keep our country free. I think about the ones who gave it all, stood up proud when they heard their nation's call. I think of the honor and the fame, the glory and the pain of those who fought and died standing tall. So here's to the soldiers, the sailors and fires and those lost out at sea. Let's all give thanks in our own way, but not just on Memorial Day, to the ones who died to keep our country free. Thank you.
horses stretch out like the sea. Down in Arlington National Cemetery, as you look out on that scene, I hope they realize what it means, that they gave their lives to protect you and me. So here's to the soldiers, the sailors and marines, to the fires and those lost out at sea.
Memorial Day, called Memorial Day. Thank you for the kind words out there. Welcome, everyone. It's good to see you. Louis Lamana, Edward Bell out there. Hey, buddy, how you doing? Ken Hope, always good to see you. Rob Robles saying it's hot and sticky down there in Florida. Rusty Taylor figuring out how to pay for the Georgia Cigarbox Guitar Fest later this year. Rick Flink out there, we are glad you're with us. You know, it being the Friday before a long weekend, we expect the viewer counts to be down a little bit. People out there doing stuff, having fun. But we are glad that you, John Matrician, we are glad that you and everyone are with us here today. It's true. As you've heard me talking about, I've got an upcoming adventure. 27 days from now, not that anybody's counting them down, but I'm going to be taking my cross-country train trip, it's around the country train trip, and I just took a new blog post live on cbgitty.com, I think it was yesterday, talking about a subject we've covered before, but the hobo tags, the modern hobo tags that you can still see on the freight cars rolling around the country, and how for me, seeing one I recognize is kind of like seeing an old friend. But of course, an old friend that I've never actually met. You know, so if you're interested in that sort of thing, get on cbgitty.com and you'll see that blog post over on the left-hand side. You can also take a look at some of the work that Shane has done this week on improving the categories. Those categories you see in the menu of different products. He's gone through all of those top-level categories and basically selected some of our best stuff to show up in there when you click on one of those categories. You can still see all the stuff through the subcategories, but basically like the best of the best products now show up in those top level categories. So it's a good thing. What's our next video, Mr. Nick Lanciano?
Let's toss it over to Shane for Glenn Patterson.
Oh, he's tossing away over there, isn't he? Look at him.
Oh, just tossing it away.
Okay, good. We better stop before this goes off the rails. Shane Spiel, what's he talking about in this one?
He's playing Glenn Kaiser's.
A two-string guitar built by the one and only Glenn Kaiser.
So I tuned this in octaves, and I don't even know what note it's tuned to. Here, let me see. Tuned somewhere close to a B flat. All right, let's get a little weird here. All right, some of you guys have asked me to show off some of the guitars that I have behind me here in my music room. And I figured I'd pull one out that I've been wanting to show forever. It looks very basic, but this one is extremely special to me. This is a ductwork guitar, all metal, that was made by one of my biggest musical influences ever, Glenn Kaiser. Now, Glenn Kaiser, if you don't know, Glenn Kaiser was a member of the Resurrection Band. They eventually shortened their name to Res Band, and they were one of the most popular Christian rock bands out there in the 70s and 80s. In fact, when it comes to Christian hard rock, a lot of people say Res Band invented it. Well, I was into Res Band back 7th grade, you know, I was that young. And later on in life, whenever I was building cigar box guitars and getting into deep blues, I discovered that Glenn had put out a couple amazing blues albums with Daryl Mansfield. It's called Kaiser Mansfield. Look those up on YouTube. Incredible old gospel Delta blues. Well, Glenn Kaiser now is playing cigar box guitars and he's making them. And he made this one for me a couple years ago. It's all just ductwork, or I don't even know if this is ductwork, or I think it may be roofing tin, because where he lives in a ministry in Chicago called Jesus People USA, and it's a homeless shelter where they bring people in and they get them employed and back on their feet. And one of the things they do is I think they have like a roofing company that employs these folks. And Glenn was hanging out there one day as they were making metal roofing, and he built this for me. It's just a metal box with a metal pipe and two strings wired to some eye bolts. Now you got to use a screwdriver to get this thing in tune, and for the bridge, it is two different bolts here. And Glenn's idea was you could change the string length for each string if you wanted to get into some weird experimental playing. And I have yet to really dive into that because it sounds out of tune to most ears. So Glenn made this for me. And imagine your greatest musical hero making you a guitar. That's how special this is to me. So this was inside the Cigar Box Guitar Museum at Spiel's Tavern in New Alexandria, PA. It's been there for several years as part of the display, and recently I took it down along with a lot of other instruments because I like to change it up. And I brought this home and I'm playing it again. So I tune this in octaves, and I don't even know what note it's tuned to. Here, let me see. Tuned somewhere close to a B flat. So there's a low B-flat and a high B-flat. And it's close, it's a little off. I almost treat this like a diddly bow sometimes where I'm playing both strings the whole time. Or I'll let one string drone out and I'll play leads on the other. That drone, you can do some R.L. Burnside. Well, see my jump along, hanging on that line. Oh, see my jump along, hanging on that line. I know by then, there's something on my mind. Been for you, wouldn't be here, baby. Hadn't been for you. The way you give me love, long the way you wanna, the way you wanna do. A little girl, let me go to bed. Fix my supper, girl, let me go to bed. all that white lightning has gone to my head. Sing, all that white lightning gone to my head. So there it is, the Glenn Kaiser metal guitar. If you're going to ask me what my favorite Glenn Kaiser song is, I think it's this one right here.
Shane Spiel, baby, you know how to keep it real. Shane Spiel, you know how to keep it real. I'm an archangel, living large. Just like on a Mississippi barge. I love to play my song. Play his canjo all night long. Shane Spiel, Shane Spiel, you know I keep it real. Shane Spiel, Shane Spiel, baby, keep on keeping it real.
Thank you, Shane, for putting that together. Nice to see you, of course, and a little snippet of Mr. Kaiser himself there at the end. Good stuff. So, Danny, you've got a song. It's another one that has been played and sung on this show before, but I don't think by Dan. And it's written by Eric Bogle back in the 70s,
yeah,
I imagine.
76, I think he wrote it.
It's a good song for Memorial Day. It kind of questions why all those... people had to die in the first place, but it's a good question to ask. Well, question worth asking once in a while.
Yeah.
It's called The Green Fields of France.
Yeah, I love the lyrics in this song. I get teary-eyed sometimes singing them.
Well, how do you do, young Willie McBride? Do you mind if I sit here down by your graveside? Rest for a while, neath the warm summer sun. I've been walking all day, I'm nearly done. I see by a gravestone, you were only 19, when you joined the great fallen in 1916. I hope you died quick, and I hope you died clean, or young Willie McBride. Was it slow and obscene? Did they beat the drum slowly? Did they play the fife lowly? Did they sound the death march as they lowered you down? Did the band play the last post in chorus? The pipes play the flowers of the forest. Did you leave a wife or a sweetheart behind? In some faithful heart is your memory enshrined. Although you died back in 1916, in that faithful heart are you forever 19? Or are you a stranger without even a name? Forever enclosed behind a glass frame, in an old photograph, torn, tattered and stained, faded to yellow in a brown leather frame. Did they beat the drum slowly? Did they play the fiddle lowly? Did they sound the death march as they lowered you down? Did the band play the last post in chorus? Did the pipes play the flowers of the forest? The sun it now shines on these green fields firing now. Here in this graveyard, it's still no man's land. The countless white crosses in mute witness stand to man's blind indifference to his fellow man, to a whole generation that were butchered and damned. Did they beat the drum slowly? Did they play the flute lowly? Did they sound the death march as they lowered you down? Did the band play the last post in chorus?
That's a good one. Well, what else we got?
Well, we got Kale playing a Western improv on a 2x4 lap steel.
Oh, buddy, that sounds good.
I think it's a pizza paddle bass.
Pizza paddle bass and a 2x4 lap steel. Here's our good buddy and regular contributor, Mr. Kale, of Pornus Studios down there in Texas, taking a couple of his favorite homemade instruments for a run. So we'll be back with you. Thank you, Kale, for sending that in. That sounded really good. There's something about I couldn't tell if that was like the Nashville C6 tuning that he had on there. Because we sell a couple of string sets for those 2x4 lap steels, and it really gives it that unique pedal steel, lap steel sound.
Makes me think of cruising down the road on a summer day with your hand out the window like that.
It just sounds smooth. Sounds like chrome.
In a vintage car.
Sounds like how chrome looks.
Yes, car. Like a 50s car.
Yeah. So just a brief aside now. Most of you probably recognize this, right? This is an Acid Cigars, Drew Estate Acid Cigars box. One of their more popular sizes. Well, we call it the Cuba Cuba size. This one is apparently plush. But if you've ever tried to use one of these boxes, you probably know they present some challenges.
It is the C6.
Good. Thank you, Kale. Kale over on YouTube.
Yes.
Hello to all of our YouTube watchers out there, even though I can't see your names here.
William Driscoll.
William Driscoll.
Kale. Kenneth Hope.
Ken Hope.
Howdy.
Ken's on both. Ken was on Facebook,
too. Yeah, I think he's double.
He's everywhere!
In case one cuts out.
Well, you ought to be sure.
Double Abel.
Oh, good to see here, at least, that all of you are out there. But yes, these acid boxes. So, challenge number one. Or let's talk about what's cool about them first. They are fairly plentiful. Very popular style of cigar. The boxes, the four side panels and that top, solid wood. Solid, it's either mahogany or Spanish cedar. I'm guessing Spanish cedar by how far I can get my thumbnail into it. Which is not cheap wood. You know, there aren't that many cigar boxes still made from solid wood. The bottoms are thin plywood. So that is what's cool about them. Now, challenges. These tops are wicked thick. About 3/8 of an inch thick. Once you get up over this little rim, this edge rim that's on them. So that's a challenge. That is a bit thick to expect good resonance out of, acoustic resonance. Another challenge is their size. They are kind of pretty much square. They are thick, about 6, maybe 7 inches square,
about
roughly.
Seven and a quarter.
Yeah. So for an instrument, for a ukulele or something smaller like that, but them not being all that long, depending on how you set your uke up, getting the bridge in the right place, and of course, that thick top. I don't think I'm getting comments anymore on here. There's some comments, all right. Our challenges. Another challenge, if you have ever tried to get these labels off, whatever adhesive they use, some kind of double-sided tape or something under there, it can be extremely difficult. We actually have a top secret method here in the Gitty shop that we found after a lot of searching that will remove that stickum that they use, and it is golf club grip solvent. If you go on Amazon and search for grip solvent, you can get small bottles. We get it by the gallon jug. Whatever horrible cancer-causing chemicals are in that stuff will dissolve the adhesive they use on these acid boxes. Because we use these acid boxes. Is there an amp over there made out of one, Nick?
I don't think so.
Oh, it's right there, Danny. Grab that. We've been using these boxes for years for making some amps, and some pretty nice amps, including one we call the Large Scent, because it has a big copper coin right there, dual speaker, volume tone control. Looks really cool. Now, you probably can't tell, but for these amps, to do all of the laser engraving and cutting, we actually use the back of the acid box because the front or the lid would be a little too thick. The pot shafts wouldn't go all the way through. We'd have to thin that out. The jacks, everything would be difficult. So we use the bottom panel or the back panel, which is made from that thin plywood. But the reason I brought all of this up was not to brag about our amplifier building, but to ask, to put the question out there, what are some creative ways you have used acid boxes? Because if you've ever gone to a cigar shop to get empty boxes, you've probably seen them. They are a very popular brand, and there are a lot of these out there.
Even more so since Swisher bought them.
Swisher bought Drew Estate?
Oh, yeah.
First cigar I ever smoked was a Swisher Sweet. Plastic tip.
Yeah. Why you see acids in no, wood. Gas stations now.
No, wooden tip with the sweet, you know, they put the little bit of sugar on. Anyway, Swisher bought all of Drew Estate?
Uh-huh.
Wow. Somebody making money.
A couple years ago. That's why you see acids in gas stations
now. All right. I don't keep up on these things, but, yeah, I'd like to see, send to support at cbgitty.com. Things you've done with these boxes. I've seen people make lamps out of them, purses, of course, amplifiers. I built, in my earlier building days, back when I was still in the basement of my house, actually before CB Gitty really became a thing, I built a four-string Irish tenor banjo-type instrument using one of these as the body. I used the thick lid as the soundboard, and the resulting instrument didn't have a lot of acoustic resonance. So, yeah, you'll have that. All right. Did you have another song? You were talking about...
I should play something on this.
Yeah, you play something on that new guitar there. Yeah, Jim Burt's saying he's going to be... he and his wife are going to be up here in July.
Oh, boy. Well,
that's coming right up, by gosh. That'll be a good show if you're here on a Friday, Jim. Bye. Golly, we'll have to get some cold beer and
crown,
pick some good old songs.
Crown with some cubes.
Keep talking, I'm still trying.
All right, just keep vamping. You're doing great.
Let's see something come.
See if he picks up one I actually know, or if I'm gonna be just watching. Either way's fine.
I was going to do Mersch and Durkin, but the third verse is eluding me. Of course, the girls in Blarney, and remember that.
Kirk and in Blarney.
I remember that one. So goodbye to all my boys. Okay.
Ah!
Now the first verse is eluding me.
Days when I was carting.
Thank you. In the days when I was carting, I was never tired resorting to the animals. Oh, we got a tune.
If those are new strings, you might have slipped away. Here you go.
Sliding away.
New strings, folks. New guitar, new strings.
Yeah,
we'll run a video. Oh. How about that? While we sort ourselves out.
Yeah, while we get ourselves somewhat organized.
Oh, they probably want an update on the fiddle. There, Nikolai.
Oh, yeah.
The great fiddle excursion of Hey, there he is!
So I went to put the tailpiece on today and really went to screw into the new spacer.
Oh, wait, hang on. There we go. Ha-ha.
Turn
the mic on. We'll
look
help.
At that, would you?
I made a spacer, and I was going to put it out there, and I twisted the screw head off as I was installing it, because I figured at least I'll get it in there, get an extra bit for the scale length. And I didn't have time to fix it. But now I'm gonna take the bottom, and Ben had suggested making like a little cutout, more of a traditional violin type shape. So I'm gonna do that, put a rest in there, and hopefully build it out a little bit.
But not this week.
Not today!
There may come a day when the fiddle will be finished, but it is not this day!
Let me send it over to Shane for some metal, or do you guys wanna play first?
Send it over to Shane, and we'll actually practice this once before we...
Okay.
Alrighty then.
Just the one!
We'll be back in 7 minutes.
This is my Beat to Hell Tommy O 3-string. It's actually a solid body guitar that I've used extensively in concert for almost 10 years. Quite honestly, in the last year I haven't used it much because the band has gone more acoustic. and this just kind of doesn't fit us as much anymore. You want a fun little effect right there? I'm in open G, close to open G, extreme distortion. Go to the fifth fret, and then take the pick behind the slide. But I wanted to show this off because I visited this before. I wanted to go back into it. This guitar is hack-wired. I put a Psycho knob in there. The Psycho knob is an internal distortion unit sold by cbgitty.com. And it has a five position. Wait, one, two, three, four, five. Four position, and the fifth position is off, of different levels of distortion. And for this guitar, I've got the snake oil pickup in here. And then the Psycho knob is here. And I took the old pickup that was here and I put the battery for the Psycho knob because it has a battery to make it work. And this is fun. If you guys are building cigar box guitars and you just want to go stupid nuts and have that one toy in your arsenal that you can just go goofy with, put a Psycho knob in there. You need a magnetic pickup, not a piezo. It'll destroy a piezo pickup. It'll just give you nothing but feedback. No, it's got to have a magnetic pickup here. And there it is. Here's the guitar clean. I'm a little out of tune. I think it's at G. No, I'm not. Close enough. So the Psycho knob, the first position, gives you more of a bite. Second. And the last one is just sick. Again, if you want to build that one guitar that's just fun and goofy to play with, get a Psycho knob. They're cheap. CB Gitty has them. And put it in one. I mean, you just have so much fun with this thing. Sustain forever. That last distortion is just sick. By the way, I'm using the King Slide from stubbyslide.com. That gives me the fast. That's another thing, that if you get into this high gain, high distortion slide stuff, have you noticed whenever I'm playing those leads over here, my picking hand, all it's doing is dampening the two strings that aren't playing, you know? It's just holding these two strings right there, and then I'll use that finger to pull off that one string if needed, but everything else is in this hand, hammer-on. So if you're working on scales up and down one string, you can, you know, do it high gain and have a little fun with your lessons. So, just a fun thing to show off to you guys. My goal is to inspire you, whether it be in your playing or in your building. I have such a massive collection of these cigar box guitars, I'm going to slowly start bringing them out and getting, you know, kind of showing you why I like each particular one and what each one does best. This thing is just a rock monster. I mean, if Ted Nugent played cigar box guitar, he'd play this, you know, basically. So, Psycho Knob, that's a, just have, you know, I dare you, put one in one of your electric cigar box guitars that has a magnetic pickup. Each of these things comes with directions, it'll show you how to do it. Highly recommended, though. So, here's my fun little video for today. My name is Shane Spiel. Check me out at shanespiel.com. So, all right, here's where we do all the fun stuff. Okay, first of all, subscribe, because I'm going to give you a lot more videos. Go to stubbyslide.com to support this channel, and then check out these other videos over here for a lot more lessons. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
Yeah, buddy, is there anything, such a thing as too much distortion?
I don't know.
Well, thank you, Shane, for putting that together. That one has actually been in the hopper for a while. We keep not getting to it. Well, today we did. Welcome to Sue Messias out there, tuning in part of the way through. And in honor of this new train locomotive themed guitar that Danny has built, we're going to do another song that, I'm not sure it's a true train song, but it mentions trains, and it's a good one, and he sings it so well, so no pressure.
Hopefully.
Be that lonesome dip on. He sounds too blue to fly. The midnight train is winding through. I'm so lonesome I could cry.
Squandered another perfectly good hour with us here, and we are glad you did. Gitty Gang Show, we should be back with you next week, right?
Yeah.
Sure, why not?
You
know, when planning this upcoming train trip of mine, I was thinking how cool it would be to take this guitar for the whole trip and get a lot of good videos playing it, maybe busking some train stations and such. And then I pick it up, I'm like, It is too big and too heavy.
Yeah, that's perfect for a hobo fiddle.
Yeah, the hobo fiddle will be going with me, definitely. All right, so you know what time it is. It's time to tune this hubcap howler. And we're going to play the Gitty Gang theme song. If you've got your favorite Gitty nearby that happens to be tuned, unlike this one, and in the key of G, GDG, well, I'd like you to pluck along with us and maybe sing. It would be cool, actually, those of you who do play and sing, it'd be pretty neat to do a montage, record yourself singing at least some of the Gitty Gang Show theme song. Maybe write a new verse or sing one of the verses we sing, record it, send it in, and we could patch them all together into...
Done it in the past.
Yeah, buddy. With that song? No.
What?
With the theme song?
No.
Okay.
But videos patched in.
Ish. All weekend long. You can get that stick and that box.